Hello and a very warm welcome to our online service for Sunday the 29th of November. Today is Advent Sunday, and Advent is those 4 weeks leading up to Christmas. And during this season of Advent, we're not only preparing to celebrate the birth of Jesus at Christmas, we look forward to that day when he will return in power and glory to judge the world. So it is a season of expectant and joyful waiting for the return of our Lord and Saviour. So as we begin our worship today, let's open with a word of prayer. A voice cries out, "Prepare for God's arrival. Make the road straight and smooth, a highway fit for our God. Fill in the valleys and level off the hills. Smooth out the ruts and clear out the rocks. For God is coming." So let's worship him today. Heavenly Father, as we worship you today, we pray that you will help remove all the things that would get in the way from us receiving and welcoming you afresh in our hearts today. So as we worship you, Lord Jesus Christ, we pray, come Holy Spirit and fill us anew so that we can welcome you this day. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We're going to sing our first hymn, which is that great Advent hymn, O Come, Emmanuel.
Oh, come thou King of days. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. You have enlarged the nation and increased their joy. They rejoice before you as people rejoice at the harvest, as warriors rejoice when dividing the plunder. For as in the day of Midian's defeat, you have shattered the yoke that burdens them, the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor. Every warrior's boot used in battle and every garment rolled in blood will be destined for burning, will be fuel for the fire. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders. And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government and peace there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time on and forever. The zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this.
The sort of tagline for this morning's service was Deck the Halls with Hope, and I thought, what a fantastic tagline to have. We have a hope in Jesus that will never disappoint us. And that got me thinking of decking the halls, usually with holly or with decorations. And anybody like me has been spending this weekend just doing that. So I thought today we could make a bit of a deck the hall decoration. So this, if I'd done the whole of it, would be a garland that read, Jesus, the hope of Christmas. And very cleverly, I've made it so it's 24 little Christmas trees. So if you wanted to, each day you could decorate a Christmas tree until we get to Christmas Day, and that would be full with telling us about the hope Jesus brings at Christmas. So it's quite simple this week. So in your envelope, you have got 3 sheets of little cardboard trees. As I say, there'll be 24 in total. So you just need to cut them out and sellotape them onto the gold thread that'll be in your envelope as well. I find that if you put the thread not at the very top, it just makes it hang a bit better. Enjoy getting ready for Christmas, and enjoy looking forward to the hope that Jesus brings us.
Our preacher this morning is the Revd David Newlove, who is a member of the Two Rivers Mission Community, of which we are part. He is also the circuit superintendent for the North Cumbria Methodist Circuit.
Good evening, everyone, and greetings from your sister churches on Wigton Road and Newtown. It's great to be with you. I've put my tie on. Partly, I just wanted to show Simon up, but I'll be honest. The thing I've missed during lockdown, both lockdowns, has been wearing a tie. I just like to get dressed up every now and again and feel a bit different. And I've put it on for you. So this is my big moment, my first tie this year, I think. But it's great to be with you, and it's great to be sharing in this service. Thank you. Thank you for the invitation, Simon. I'm honoured. It's vital, and it's a move of the Spirit that we are working together more closely across our mission community. And I look forward to this in this coming year with eager anticipation, as we reflect on Vision Refresh and the other ways in which we can share our faith and build community and celebrate all that God has given to us together. And I look forward to that with you. It's great and it's a privilege that we can share together tonight as we enter into this holy season of Advent and share together and start ourselves off as we prepare for Christmas. This is a season of hope, and we've been given a familiar text that we've already heard tonight from Isaiah chapter 9. It's our gift, God's gift to us for tonight. I want you to hear again just two verses. Verses 2, or the end of verse 2 and verse 3. A light has dawned. You, God, have enlarged the nation and increased their joy. They rejoice before you as people rejoice at the harvest, as warriors rejoice when dividing the plunder. Amen. A light has dawned. This is certainty from Scripture. You, God, you have enlarged the nation, have already, and are continuing to do so. And you have increased our joy. And we know that fully in Christ, who we celebrate in a few weeks' time in his birth in a manger in a stable in Bethlehem. Your Advent theme for this year at St. James is Deck the Halls with Hope. A great theme and a reminder that we don't just deck our halls with boughs of holly and the trimmings and trappings of Christmas, but with the real meaning of Christmas. And our hope is in many things. Immediately, of course, our hope is an end to this pandemic and the possibility of these vaccines. Our hope is in an end to the restrictions that we currently face. Our hope is in the opportunity to come together as family and in the five-day window that we've been given over Christmas, that we can fit in all that we need to do and share with those who are most important to us. Our hope is in that we can have that sense as church family again and be together and grow together and share and nurture and love and support and encourage. And our hope is that we can celebrate Christmas and perhaps even if it's just on the doorstep on the 20th, sing a few Christmas carols together. And in terms of long term, then our hope is for family and those holidays that we couldn't take this year and reaching out into this hurting community and rebuilding and growing together again. It's important in this time that we share our hopes and our fears and listen to one another. It's vitally important. This will become a strong foundation for our return to normality. And as we return, prepare to return, my hope is that it won't be to the old normal. Pray God it's not. Because if we're honest, in church terms, it hasn't really been working quite as it ought for some time. And I think now there is a really important point for us that we need to hear from one another and from God as to what this new will be. And pray God that we don't waste this opportunity. Over these last few weeks, various verses have come to me, particularly from Isaiah, later on in the book. From Isaiah 43, verse 18, we read, "Forget the former things." It speaks right into that, not returning back to the old. But recently I've been given Isaiah 65, 17 and 18, which say again, the former things will not be remembered, nor will they come to mind. In a sense that God doesn't want us to remember the former things, but he wants to remove them from us so that we can do a new thing. I was at a cinema network leaders meeting this week and hearing about our task, our calling to prepare to clear space so that we can hear what God is doing and start those new things now. Isaiah 65 goes on to say, "But be glad and rejoice forever in what I will create." There's a calling from God, but an assurance from God here too, that God wants to move and God wants to do a new thing. And I believe that Advent for us is not just these 4 weeks as we lead up to Christmas, but we are in a time of Advent for Carlisle. And pray God that we hear what God wants to say and see where he's leading us and that we'll take that step. This is where my hope is. In what God will create and birth from this pandemic. Something with eternal consequences. So what are the key things that we need to think about? What are those things that we need to lay down or to let die so that we make space for the new? What are those things that we are not going to hanker after, that we're going to resist? And that's key in this time of waiting, both for us spiritually as we prepare for Christmas, and we hear again that the familiar story in preparation as we travel through Advent. What is it that God is saying to us now, that Christmas may be as it was in our first hearing? And in all of this, where is our hope? What do we hope in? What is God calling us to say to the church? What is God calling us to do? Ultimately, of course, we will all say, my hope is in the Lord, and amen. But what about in the immediate? What is your hope now? What is your hope for St. James? What is St. James's hope as the body of Christ? What is the hope that we are seeing in Carlisle? Now, usually when I've been preaching, my pattern seems to be God's given me to do 3 points. I've not got 3 points. I've got 4 interrelated points. And they're quite simple and straightforward. They are based around the acrostic on the word hope. And as we enter this unique Advent, we've never had an Advent like this before. Pray God we don't again. In this season of watching and waiting, what does hope mean for us? And I want to suggest 4 things. The H stands for humility. Not as in, oh, you're better than me at this. You do it because you'll do it in a way that I can't. And we have, sometimes we make that humility something false. It becomes an excuse to not do something. Oh, I'm no good at that. I can't do that. And we resist God's call. The humility in knowing that God is God and that God will do again what God will do. And that as God showed us in that vulnerable little baby in a manger in Bethlehem, that our task, our calling is to yield to him in obedience. And God will show us what he is doing. The light has dawned. God has enlarged the nation. God has increased their joy. When we humble ourselves before God, when we are obedient to him and follow him and give the whole of our life to him, then God will be able to do that again. He'll be able to do it again, of course, without us, but better with. And then we receive that joy. God has enlarged the nation. Let's be humble before him. H for humility, O for openness. If that is God, if that is who we follow, if that is who we serve, then how are we going to open ourselves afresh to him this Advent? How are we going to allow him to speak? Normally, of course, we get busier and busier as we do our Christmas shopping and as we go to our parties and our events and preparations. We don't have a lot of that. What we've been gifted with this Advent is time. How are we going to use that time to be open to God and to hear him afresh for what he wants to call us to in the future? What is God saying? Where is God leading us? Well, that you can see now that you couldn't see before. What are you being called to be open to in this new world? Humility, openness, and a P for purpose. If you ever say purpose, my ears prick up. I love purpose. I love things to be purposeful. For me, it's about being focused on the important things, the things that matter. And that's why Advent is such a vital theme, It prepares us for Christmas. We, as a world, run full tilt through December and we arrive at Christmas and think, oh, I've missed out on all that preparation, all that time, all that waiting, all that looking forward to. It's a time for us to slow down and to listen to God and to be focused on the things that God wants. And the great Advent theme is, of course, preparing the way of the Lord. How does he wish us to prepare his way? How does he wish us to share in that great mission in our community? How does he want us to be focused on the harvest that he has prepared for us? Are we humble before God? Are we open to his leading and the leading of the Holy Spirit? Are we open to his purpose? And finally, and fundamentally, an E for enjoyment. We can get so wrapped up in this pandemic, so wrapped up in things of church that we lose out on the joy. And things become a burden. And I understand how hard things are and how difficult it is for so many and for us at this time. But we know that even within the greatest turmoil, there is a peace and an enjoyment that comes from God and that eternal hope that we have in him. Verse 3 says, and he, God, increased their joy. As we humbly come before him, as we open ourselves to him, as we focus on his purpose, so that enjoyment comes in the fulfillment of his promises. To rejoice is to accept the blessing of being a part of his anointment. I want to offer to you these four aspects of the hope that we deck our halls with, that we decorate our lives and our homes with, that we decorate them with humility before God, that we decorate them with openness to God, that we decorate them with our calling to his purpose, but that we decorate them too with enjoyment, that when we come to the 25th of December, when we get to the end of Advent, when Christmas starts, we can celebrate afresh the birth of the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, that Christ comes as one of us, for us, that we can be with him as one of his. May God bless you and guide you as you travel through this Advent series and this season of Advent. As you deck your halls with hope, may you know God's blessing, God's peace and God's joy. And I pray that you look forward with anticipation for all that we can do together as a mission community and across our city in his name, as he takes us and as he leads us, as we give ourselves, as we yield ourselves afresh to him, to the glory of his name. Amen.
Oh, can you hear the angel song that rang so sweet and clear? When heaven's light and music fell, and mercy found us here. Glory in the highest, and on the earth be peace. Glory to God, the angels sing. He came to tell the Father's love, his goodness and his grace, to show the brightness of his smile, the glory of his face. So glory in the highest, and on the earth be peace. Glory to God, your children sing. His name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace, for all eternity. Oh, his name shall be. He came to lift the weary give peace and perfect rest, to take away our burdens and to give a glorious gift. So glory in the highest, and on the earth be peace. Glory to God, the world will sing. His name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace, for all eternity. Oh, His name shall
Let us bring our thanks and prayers to our Lord and Saviour. We thank you, Lord, for the gift of life and for the gift of health, for the gift of being living in a secure land, and for the gift of blessings of food and drink and housing. We also thank you that we live in a safe and secure country despite the recent pandemic. As Christians, we are asked to bring our requests to God, and we come before you, Lord, bringing you some of our needs, knowing that you have heard us when we gather and ask in your name. We pray for this season of Advent. We pray for our leaders, Simon and Nina, and their families, especially as they prepare for Christmas and make decisions about Christmas and what to include in services, etc. So pray for them. And we also pray for members of our church family who have various needs and are struggling in various ways. We pray for all those with health issues and those who have lost friends and family recently. Pray for the family, particularly for the family of Bob Deans, following the death of his daughter, Helen. Pray that you will comfort them at this time. Pray for John and June Edwards. For Fran McCubbing, Thank you that there's been a response to a treatment for her lymphoma. We pray for Gerald Irwin, for Stuart Rowe, for Rosie Thwaites and Norma Turner. We thank you, Father, that you know the needs of each of these people and that you are there to listen. And we ask that there will be our prayers will be answered, Lord, soon, that you will relieve them from their pain or suffering. And we pray for those who we haven't prayed for in our church, who have needs, either physical or mental, that you will minister for them, Father. We also pray for the future of Comersdale Church. Pray that you'll guide those who make those decisions. Lord, we pray for our mission partners in spreading the gospel. We pray for Hamsaye International. We pray for Miriam Westfall, for Gary Iron with the Church Missionary Society, for Tear Fund in the good work they do around the world, for the Langham Partnership, for Santa Soli in Montenegro, for the Fletcher family in Bangkok, and also for a church link in Sola in Norway. Lord, I just pray, Father, that you will fill these people with your spirit this Christmas and meet their needs and help them to as they spread the gospel and spread your word. Pray for our leaders in the church. We pray for Bishops Emma and James. And moving from the church to the secular world, we pray for our local MP, John Stevenson. Give him good health and help him make wise decisions and help him to serve with integrity and wisdom. And also we pray for the government of Mr. Boris Johnson in London. We ask to respect our leaders. And Lord, I just pray that you'll give them great wisdom in running this country in this very difficult time of coronavirus. The coronavirus itself has had a terrible toll on people's mental health, both locally and nationally and internationally. We pray that you will meet, many people will come to find you in this time of testing. The first time we've been in a kind of area of uncertainty and lack of control of our lives. We pray that the hopes of a vaccine will be realized very soon and that we can continue with normal lives. We pray for refugees, Lord, across the world. There are many millions of people who have been forced to flee from war and famine and persecution. Pray that you will bless and help them. Pray for the refugees in Carlisle. Pray for the Syrian refugees who are already settled here. Pray that they will receive a very warm welcome, that they will settle quickly, and that they will soon be feeling at home and making a very valuable contribution to this land. We also pray for refugees in large parts of Europe, in Calais, in southern Europe, in Greece. Pray that people will be merciful and kind to them and that give them some kind of home. We pray especially for child refugees who are in a desperate situation. Lord, we have so many needs that we've brought before you, but we are confident that you have heard our prayer. So we thank you for this today and we ask this in your name. Amen.
These are the days of Elijah, declaring the word of the Lord, and these are the days of your servant Moses, righteousness being restored. And all these are days of great trial, of famine and darkness and sore. Still we are the voice in the desert crying, prepare ye the way of the Lord. Behold, he comes, riding on a cloud, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, lift your voice. It's the year of Jubilee, and out of Zion's hill salvation. And these are the days of Ezekiel,
the dry bones becoming as fresh. And these are the days of your servant David, rebuilding a temple of praise. And these are the days of the harvest, the fields are all white in the world, and we are the laborers in your vineyard, declaring the word of the Lord. Behold, he comes, riding on a cloud, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, lift your voice, it's the year of Jubilee, and out of Zion's hill, salvation comes. Behold, he comes, riding on a cloud, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, lift your voice, it's the year of Jubilee, and out of Zion's hill, salvation comes. There is no God like Jehovah, 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 there is no God like Jehovah. Behold, he comes, riding on a cloud, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, lift your voice, it's the year of Jubilee, and out of Zion's hill, salvation comes. Behold, he comes, riding on a cloud, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, lift your voice, it's the year of Jubilee, and out of Zion's hill, salvation.
As our service draws to a close, just a few notices of events happening in the next couple of weeks. First of all, tomorrow night at 7:30 p.m. we will be continuing with the prayer course, and on Wednesday evening at 7:30 p.m. we have our monthly prayer and praise, and that will be taking place on Zoom, so I do hope you will be able to join us for that. On Saturday, the 5th of December, we will be starting the Effective Listening course. This is going to be run by the Acorn Christian Healing Foundation, and it will be taking place over the two mornings, Saturday the 5th of December and Saturday the 12th of December. I did the Effective Listening course many years ago when I was a curate, and I can really recommend it. We have just a few spaces left on that course, so if you'd like to take part, please do get in touch with me as soon as possible. Next Sunday, the 6th of December, will be our gift and pledge day. Now, next Sunday is going to be special because we are going to be reopening St. James Church in Denton Home for morning worship. So there will be a service in St. James Church, Denton Home, at 10:30 a.m. next Sunday, and that will be a service of Holy Communion. Now, there won't be children's groups next Sunday. One of the reasons for that is that some of our families are going to be going to Stockswood, where there is an outdoor school, outdoor forest school, and they're going to be doing activities and fun events there together. So next Sunday service will be a service of Holy Communion in St. James, and we will stream that through Facebook. Now, as it is our gift and pledge day, I would ask you to prayerfully consider if you are able to make a financial gift to support the work of St. James. And you can bring that gift with you either to church next Sunday morning at 10:30, or you can post it to the parish centre, or alternatively, you might like to give online or make a bank transfer. And details of how to do that can be found on our website, so please do go and look there. Just looking a little bit further ahead, on Sunday the 13th of December, we're going to have a special service at 3 p.m., which is called a Blue Christmas service. Now, if you're not familiar with a Blue Christmas service, this is a service that acknowledges the fact that for many people, the run-up to Christmas can be quite a difficult and challenging time, especially those who might be on their own or who have suffered bereavement or some other form of loss, maybe loss of job. And a Blue Christmas service is a service of hope and healing. And it will be taking place in St. James Church, COVID permitting, at 3 p.m. on Sunday the 13th of December. So if you know anyone who you think would value that service, and please do invite them to come along, do encourage them to come along. It's a quiet and reflective service, and I hope it will give a lot of help and hope and support to people who might be struggling at the moment, particularly this year with everything that has happened during 2020. And just finally, just a couple of announcements, greetings. First of all, to say that this week, Joan Yarker will be celebrating her 80th birthday. So Joan, on behalf of everyone at St. James, I want to wish you a very happy birthday and thank you for all you do to serve the church. And also, just to say best wishes and to send our love and prayers to Joe Ray and to Martin Shirley, who will be getting married this coming Saturday in St. James at 12 p.m. So this wedding has been postponed several times this year. So we're really delighted, really excited that that wedding can go ahead on Saturday. And we wish Joe and Martin all our best wishes and send them our love and prayers for that very special day. So, as we draw our worship to a close now, let's finish with prayer. So may we go out and disrupt what is wrong in the world, what is unjust and what is hateful. May we nurture and plant seeds of love wherever we may go. And may we celebrate the coming of Emmanuel, God with us. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son and the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen.